Mark, the way I try to explain the South to so many people who don't live here is I try to use the example of the Civil War. When you had people living basically in poverty that were sharecroppers, they weren't the aristocracy. They were not the land owners. They were the people who worked the land for the aristocracy. And nevertheless, they were convinced by the aristocracy that they should take their gun and run into the face of cannons and just basically become cannon fodder. And they did it not for any other reason except that they felt this weird obligation to that aristocracy, even though they had nothing. I mean, the aristocracy would not let them come through their back door of their palatial mansions, but right. They did this anyway. And you nailed this article, Southern Discomfort. It's very, very good stuff because people don't understand this Southern mentality. Tell me what you think about what the Democrats ought to do here with the South. You know, mine is turn out the lights and go home. I'm interested in seeing what your view is.
Well, I don't want to turn out the lights and go home. I think what I'm trying to say is that even if you're not going to count on the South as in elections, you know, traditionally Democrats really did count on the South in elections. You know, Jimmy Carter won everything except Virginia. Bill Clinton wouldn't have been elected without winning some states in the South. But now it's possible for Democrats to see a way to work around that, both in presidential elections and in, you know, ultimately in building congressional majorities again. The challenge, I think, is that I wouldn't turn off the lights and go home.
Well, look,
I think we have an obligation to, you know, to the enormous level of need in the South. Somebody just sent me an email about all the education cuts in Texas. I mean, that's a lot of kids whose teachers are going to be fired and whose schools are going to get worse than they already are. Well, that's something that Democrats are obligated to think about.
No question. But in the process, Mark, yeah, child poverty all-time high, incarceration, infant mortality, lowest rates of health insurance, student achievement is abysmal. Union representation is non-existent. The environment is in a deplorable condition. But what it comes down to is the same thing LBJ knew when he signed civil rights legislation. He said the South is forever gone. And so I think you're almost beating your head up against the wall to turn that around. And that's why I know that the end of your article, you say that we can't give up. But I'm wondering to what end.
Well, to the end of, if you think in a 20-year process, lots of things change over the course of 20 years. Politics of states have changed. An older generation, you know, moves on. Younger people all across the country are more, you know, they're more tolerant. They're more open to diversity. They're less racist. You know, all those potentials are there. The population shift, the Hispanic population in a lot of the southern states grows. I think it's possible to kind of build from the grassroots. Don't think of it just in terms of how you're going to win elections, but to build from the grassroots a little bit more of a community organizing movement that allows people to think about what they really need get away from that, you know, old ideology that's kind of trapped them.
Well, let me throw you a curve. In the South, there's a notion that concept tradition is handed down generation to generation, and it's so true. There almost is no diversity in that. For example, leadership begins in the major universities here, the University of Alabama, maybe Auburn, maybe Ole Miss, maybe University of Georgia. Those are the kids that come out, and then they're the next generation of leadership.
Right.
The problem is they are just like mommy and daddy.
Right.
And so those are the people who are still – that's the aristocracy that's still leading that Civil War sharecropper to run into the face of a cannon when he has nothing to benefit. It's zero benefit for his quality of life.
Well, you're closer to it to be able to comment on that kind of force, which certainly will affect things over the next 20 years. I mean, one criticism I've gotten of the article, and it's totally well taken, is that, you know, it's you shouldn't really generalize so broadly about the South. And I did distinguish between, you know, Virginia and North Carolina, which are increasingly more affluent states that Obama did win, and But, you know, the border states are very different. They're a little less steeped in that tradition than Deep South. On the other hand, they've been moving so rapidly away from the Democratic
You're talking about
Party.
Tennessee, Kentucky, Arkansas,
Arkansas,
used to be Clinton's stronghold, right?
Which were Clinton's stronghold. But, you know, they moved, you know, Obama lost a lot of ground compared to John Kerry in those states, but John Kerry lost a lot of ground compared to Al Gore, and Al Gore lost a lot of ground compared to Bill Clinton. So it's not just that you had an African-American candidate for president.
Right.
You know, they've been moving as quickly as possible away from the Democratic Party for a long time. And those, of course, are, you know, where there's in many ways some of the deepest poverty and the least. There's a lot of economic development in some of the other states.
Mark, I think you nailed it in your article, frankly. I don't think you overgeneralized. I think you nailed it. And again, I'm here and I read this and I read it a couple of times because I was so moved by what you wrote. I thought it was brilliant, actually. Mark, you know, the other idea here is to say, okay, and this is, again, I come at it, let me disclose, my feeling is that the Democrats, that progressives have lost the South. Okay, I'm a progressive that lives down here. Everything I do tries to further that progressive movement. It is like getting up and beating your head up against the wall, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I realize that. And so I say, for the betterment of the progressive movement, why don't we focus on Nevada or Colorado, where you have well-organized Hispanic voters, you have a labor movement, you think you can move a progressive agenda further ahead. Why not take all of that that attention and put it in places where we have a chance?
Because I can't abandon the efforts of, you know, what people like you do. And I think that different people have different roles in the system. And some people's job is to get Democrats elected. If your job is to get Democrats elected, you should be focusing on Nevada, Colorado, and so forth. If you feel like your obligation is to change that next generation, to change the way we think about, you know, our country as a whole, to change the way we think about opportunity and education, there's a lot of us who don't, you know, we don't actually do electoral politics. We're doing something else. We're trying to change the mindset of the country. We're trying to change a little bit the dynamics of power, maybe change who we consider the elites who are going to move into leadership positions in those states in some different ways. And I think if you're on that side, I think you need to be thinking about the South, and you need to be thinking about it even more so because you know that the political process isn't going to.
Yeah.
The Democratic Party is not going to care because they shouldn't care.
But there are progressives, just so you know, there's progressives down here that have year after year, I mean for decades, put in their money, put in their time, put in their heart, put in their sense of morality, conviction, and they've said, well, you know, we've done all we can do.
Right.
And
right.
And so then at some point you say, okay, you know, we can't do anything more. They, you know,
right.
they bought into the lie about Iraq, their jobs are being outsourced. Millionaires, billionaires are getting tax breaks. They're not. It's almost this. They've been stifled to this Walmart level of wages that year after year they just seems to be okay with them.
Right, right.
And so the real question then comes: is the South going to be led by the Pat Robertson type of demagogues that say that that's all good for the South, or are we going to be able to step out of it?